Today I will discuss on the Laplace transform. The main question is that why do we use the Laplace transform? Actually, we already have the time domain of natural event adversaries. Our field transform that is given by the CAT formula f minus infinity prime f in t tau minus g omega t. So why do we use Laplace transform? The answer is that, as you know, we can do the field transform of that signals that are converges, and these signals that are not converges, we cannot find the field transform. You can see here, this is our converge signal. You can see this converge signal. So we can easily found it for a transform, because we already know any signal which is converge means we can find by the direct method, but that will be always absolutely integrable. This signal is always absolutely integrable, as already discussed about it, but this signal is not absolutely integrable. Here you can see that f t comma dt is less than not definite, so we cannot find Fourier transform of not definite. We cannot find the Fourier transform of that particular signal. So here we introduce the Laplace transform tool. This same signal to the integral form of the Fourier transform, we can convert any time domain into frequency domain signal, and also we can find solution of this type of non-absolute integrable signals. We can find the frequency domain of that type of signals also. Now, how can we find the Laplace transform or frequency domain of this type of signals? So here we can see how can we find the frequency domain or Laplace transform or Fourier transform of that particular type of signal. First, we will check how can we return of this signal. Like, we can write this signal as e to the power 3t into multiply of a particular signal of ft. We make this signal as absolutely integrable. How can we make this signal as absolutely integrable? That of signals, we can convert e to the power 3t ut multiply by e to the power minus k 5t. We can add one signal e to the power minus 5t. We can keep this is a signal e to the power minus 5t. We can introduce this signal in multiplication of this particular signal. So after the multiplication, we can get the absolutely integrable signal. This is totally converged signal. So after the multiplication of particular of a constant term, we can find the Fourier transform of that particular non-integrable signal by converting into the absolutely integrable signal. This term is called the e to the power, just for example, minus sigma t, where sigma is any constant term. So here we introduce a of e to the power minus sigma t terms. That's why we can find the frequency domain of any signal, any type of signal that is converged or not converged. This is introducing of minus sigma terms in particular manner. Now, so we can say we can find the Fourier transform of any signal by introducing a term of e to the power minus sigma t and multiplication of that particular signal. If we multiply any signal by e to the power minus sigma t terms, then we can find the Fourier transform of any type of signal. Any type of integrable signal or non-integrable signal. So finding the multiplication e to the power minus sigma t by the e to the power minus sigma t terms, we can find the Fourier transform of signal. We can say also that Fourier transform of ft into of e to the power minus sigma t, where ft stands for Fourier transform. We can find the minus infinite to infinite by this particular formula, ft into e to the power minus sigma t into e to the power minus g omega t of dt. Here we introduce one term, e to the power minus sigma t. We can now see that here we can get Fourier transform e to the power minus infinite is infinite ft into e to the power minus e sigma plus e g omega of t term into of dt. Rearrange e to the power minus infinite infinite ft into e to the power minus k st of dt. This is called Fourier transform of ft into e to the power minus sigma t. Here the s main term. Here we introduce the s main term, which is given by sigma plus g omega. It's a rectangular form. You already know that rectangular form. And it can represent in the S plane just like a sigma and g omega, where our sigma is real of S, real term, and g omega is a imaginary of S. Now we can get this term. This term is called the Laplace transform. So it can also tell as Laplace transform is equal to f of s equals minus infinite to infinite f t into e to power minus k x t of dt. So for any signal we can find the time domain to frequency domain by this Laplace of this method by using the e to power minus sigma t term, where sigma is called, where sigma is called reason of convergence. Reason of convergence. Also called is ROC. For this value, we can converge any non-integrable signal into integrable signal. Thank you.